Hi everyone, and welcome to today's Alex Draws. Today I'm going to be drawing something that you may or may not know. You probably know it because it's very popular. It's going to be Donatello, the Ninja Turtle. So I had this idea in my head of how I would want Donnie to look in modern day. I know everyone has their own interpretation of stuff, which I think is going to be very interesting for this show. So the first thing I want to do is just get a gist of how I'm going to want the drawing to be. Very rough. That's how I always start, is just getting a feel for how the drawing's going to be. See, this is very misshapen. So, I'm actually going to darken the lines. And, on another layer, actually try to go more towards what I'm going to be doing. Ba, 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 ba. See, the thing about sketching before you draw is that you can get a feeling of what you want before you actually do it. So I'm going to do another really quick sketch, and it's going to be how I actually end up drawing the picture. So let's cut to that. So this is kind of what I end up going for. I kind of want him to have the sitting on the rooftop kind of look, because Ninja Turtles are always known for two things, and that's either rooftops or sewers. So I'm going for the rooftop type look, and after I have the general sketch down of what I want, I'm going to kind of actually go a little bit into drawing the actual shapes and whatnot that are going to go over the sketch. So what I'm going to want to do is get the general face layout for my version of how the turtles are going to be. Well, mainly Donnie. And after I get that down, I can start going into more detail and progressively go further and further until I have something I'm comfortable with. So the thing, once everyone starts to draw, that people have to realize, you can't get comfortable with a certain design. Like, I always hit undo, probably one of my favorite buttons to hit. See, right now I'm not really liking this, don't like the shape of the head. But either way, what I'm going to end up doing is I'm going to put this, since it's on another layer, over here. And actually just curve this a bit. And just try to do another rough sketch of how I want the drawing to end up looking. So over the sketch, I do yet another sketch. I think they have, whatever fingers. So this sketch is just for more details once more. It looks like dog hand right now. But you guys probably get the point. Okay. So now we have this other general gist of how he's going to look. And I'm going to... Alright, so that's how that looked. I'm going to do it again, and let's cut to that. So now at this point, what we have is we have the general, how kind of what we want him to look like. And now I'm going to kind of start filling in. I separated by layer, and that way I could get face and everything else down and separate it. So I'm going to kind of just go in and start filling in things that I want to be certain colors. That way I have it down for later. I'm going to do this one very differently than how I normally do photos, especially from Flash. And I'm going to be approaching it in a very different method. I want to see how it's going to look uniquely. What I tend to do is I tend to draw on Flash and then edit and fine-tune on Photoshop. It ends up, in my opinion, for myself, it ends up looking better that way. So I'm just gonna quickly color this in, and then I'm gonna fine tune it another time so I have more of exactly what I'm looking for. So here is the current finished product, and I'm liking it so far. I mean, certain things with the colors are bugging me, and the fact that this mouse is twitching like crazy is also bugging me a lot. But so I'm gonna export it as two different files. I'm gonna do one that has no color, and this is gonna be for me for reference, because this one I'm going to do no lines. It'll make sense later, but what I want to do here, since I have all these holes now, is just fill them in, and then I'm going to want to export it. So I'm just gonna do that, export it, and then load it up to Photoshop. So what I'm gonna do in Photoshop, let me just open them up first. So what I'm going to do on Photoshop actually may seem a little bit strange, because a lot of people are going to think it's backwards, but I'm actually going to put this over here. So I have one with lines, which technically I should have just done it without the white fill. I'll note that for myself next time. And I'm going to put it over the one that has no lines. And what I'm going to do now is I'm actually going to do shading around this. So I'm going to create the lines with the shading. And we're going to see how that looks. So I'm going to do that really quick. So here's how it looks after it's shaded, except I didn't finish the feet. So let me just do that really quick. So here's how it's basically going to look shaded. There's a really big difference from when I started to now. You probably be able to tell just from watching. I just use the overlay method, and I was able to get this look pretty easily. Highlights, midtones, shadows, you just gotta know where to put them. For the most part with lines, I did highlights, and then between joints I did different other methods. And when I finished, I would just take a highlight. I mean, I would dodge the area in the middle, so it looks like there's more of a shine to the middle of it. So you get this kind of look. So I like that right now, but it's missing obviously the background, and so here, actually, yeah, here's how it looks. Here's how it looks now. Before, now. So I like that look. I'm gonna fix up the eyes too. Right now the eyes look really crazy. Do that now really quickly. Right now the brush is too big, so let's make that smaller. Change the brush. I'm gonna be using brush 19 just to create the black in the eye. And actually some black here didn't carry over either, so I'm just gonna fill that in as well. Maybe went too harsh. I'm actually not gonna do it on this side then. I'm just gonna focus on the pupil. Then I wanna get this color, because this color seems to be missing a little bit on this side. I'm gonna fill that in. Then I wanna get a white brush. Do that little eye spark. And now the eyes already look a lot better. So now what I'm actually going to try to do is maybe apply a little bit of textures to certain areas, and if that doesn't work, or if I don't like it, I'm just going to stick to finishing it up by doing the background. So that's going to be shown right now. So here's what I have so far, and it's during nighttime, and I feel like the picture is still missing something. So I'm actually going to be doing something a little bit interesting as well. Hopefully it works the way I want it to. I did some texture on the building, actually. I ended up liking it. on the building, but I didn't really like it for the character. So let's see if this will work. So this is the finished product. I was going to do a little bit of light coming from the phone onto his face, but I think that overall this is a pretty good photo. I like it the way it turned out, so hopefully you guys do too. So what I'm just going to drop is say, please subscribe. If you have any requests, just comment below, and I'll actually try to get to as many requests as possible if there are any. I'm really trying my hardest to make sure I'm delivering some kind of content that you guys like. So hopefully you guys enjoy the picture, and thanks for watching.